Hello students, in today's class we are going to discuss about Qutbuddin Aibak. Qutbuddin Aibak was the founder of slave dynasty in India and also he founded the rule of Delhi Sultanates. Here Aibak originally was a slave of Muhammad of Ghor. Muhammad Ghor fought the second battle of Tarim with Prithviraj Chauhan in 1192 AD. And result is very clear, Muhammad of Ghor defeated Prithviraj Chauhan and captured Delhi and Ajmer. After this victory, Muhammad of Ghor appointed Qutbuddin Aibak as the governor of his Indian possessions, because Qutbuddin Aibak was one of the trusted slave and also able general of Muhammad of Ghor. So he appointed Aibak as the in charge of his Indian possessions. Here Qutbuddin was the founder of Muslim rule in India and he rose from the humble position of a slave to the elevated position of a sultan. Here he was a brave soldier and a great general. He was largely responsible for Muhammad Ghor's success in India. He assisted his master during Ghor's invasion in India. And he was a great diplomat and possessed practical wisdom. Because of that, he became the sultan in India. He was also proved his abilities by military conquest. Means he conquered many territories in India by defeating his enemies or his neighboring rulers. Here in 1206 AD, Muhammad of Ghor was died. After the death of Muhammad Ghor, Qutbuddin Aibak started his independent rule and he became the ruler of slave dynasty or Delhi Sultanates. He ruled for a brief period, that is from 1206 to 1210 AD. And during this period, Qutbuddin Aibak concentrated towards the consolidation of his power or strengthening his position in the state, because he was surrounded by enemies in all sides. So he used force both in his rule and also in administration. He maintained a strong army, and with the help of his strong army, he ruled effectively and also established the rule of Delhi Sultanates under the title slave dynasty or under the family, that is slave dynasty. Here the dynasty or the rule which was started by Qutbuddin Aibak was called as slave dynasty, because Qutbuddin Aibak was originally a slave of Muhammad Ghor. He was born in a rich family of Turks, but he was sold to this Pakruddin, a Qazi, because of his ugly appearance. In looking, Aibak was not good looking. He was not has good appearance. So he was sold by his relatives or family members to a Qazi. But this Qazi, Pakruddin, he given good education to Aibak and also military train. So after the death of Qazi Pakruddin, his brothers sold Aibak to Muhammad of Ghor. So here Aibak became a slave of Muhammad Ghor. Here Muhammad Ghor, he was very much attracted because of the military and other talents of Aibak, and he appointed this Aibak as his general or in charge of his military unit. So here, after this, he also became the viceroy. He also became viceroy because of his great qualities, or because of his own personal abilities, he also became the viceroy under the rule of Muhammad of Ghor. Here, he ruled over India, that is from 1192 AD. But from 1192 AD to 1206, he ruled as a general of Muhammad of Ghor. Means he was under the control of Muhammad of Ghor, or Muhammad of Ghor was the master of Qutbuddin Aibak, and he just ruled as a governor of Muhammad Ghor's Indian possessions. But in 1206 AD, after the death of Muhammad Ghor, this Aibak, he started his independent rule over India. He started his independent rule over India. And he also received manumission. Manumission means release from his slavery. Basically, he was a slave. And in 1206 AD, Aibak became independent ruler. Means he received that manumission from Ghiyasuddin. Ghiyasuddin, one of the nephew of Muhammad of Ghor, he accepted the request of Aibak and also agreed his independent rule. With this, Aibak, he was released from his slavery and became the Sultan of Delhi Sultanate, or independent ruler of India under slave dynasty. Here we have some of the conquests of Qutbuddin Aibak, that is military achievements of Qutbuddin Aibak. In 1192 AD, Aibak captured Delhi, Ajmer and Hansi. In 1192 AD, Aibak captured Delhi, Ajmer and Hansi. In 1194 AD, Aibak assisted Muhammad of Ghor in his war against Jai Chand of Rathod. In 1196 AD, Aibak conquered Gwalior by defeating its ruler and also collected a huge war indemnity. Or after defeating Hindu ruler of Gwalior, he made this ruler to pay huge war tributes. In 1197 AD, he defeated Raja Bhima Deva of Gujarat. In 1202 AD, he won a great victory against the Chandela ruler of Bundelkhand. In 1202 AD, Aibak defeated Chandela ruler of Bundelkhand and captured Kalinjar. So all these are some of the great victories of Aibak as a governor of Delhi province under the rule of Muhammad of Ghor. At that time, he was just as a governor of Delhi possessions of Muhammad of Ghor, and he became independent in the year 1206 AD. And when he established his independent rule, he mainly concentrated towards the consolidation of his power. I already said he was surrounded by enemies in all sides, so he given importance for consolidation of power, and he used force to rule effectively. He maintained a vast army, and with the help of that army, he ruled as a sultan, independent sultan of India. And here mainly, soon after his succession, he tried to consolidate his position and power through diplomatic measures. He used diplomatic measures to consolidate his powers soon after his succession to the throne of Delhi, means that is in 1206 AD. He gave his daughter in marriage to Iltutmish, and also he gave his sister to Nasiruddin Kabacha, that is in marriage. He means here he maintained matrimonial relations in order to establish his rule in Delhi region. Then here he himself married the daughter of Tezuddin Yalduz. He married the daughter of Tezuddin Yalduz. All these were the Muslim governors and always creating troubles to Qutbuddin Aibak. So he wanted to win the minds of these Muslim governors and also rulers. So he maintained matrimonial relations with Tezuddin, then Kabacha, Yalduz and Iltutmish. But after the death of Qutbuddin Aibak, Iltutmish, he became the successor of Aibak. Actually, Aibak had a son, that is Aram Shah, but he was not capable or able to rule over Delhi region. So here Iltutmish, he gained the chance to rule over India and started his independent rule. Here Aibak, he not given much importance to administrative reforms because he was very much busy in consolidating his powers. So he did not find time to provide a sound system of administration. He tried to rule with the help of force and he left the local administration in the hands of native rulers. For most of the time, he was preoccupied with the problem of keeping himself in power. Means he always, his enemy is creating troubles to him or some of the threats to him. So here he always given much importance to consolidating his power. And he was a patron of art and literature. He patronized some of the poets in his court. Then he also started the construction of the famous Qutub Minar at Delhi. This is one of the greatest contribution or achievement of Qutbuddin Aibak in the field of art and architecture. That is, he started the construction of Qutub Minar. Then he also built mosques at Delhi and Ajmer. So all these are some of the contributions of Aibak. Aibak was died in 1210 AD. After his death, Aram Shah was succeeded to the throne of Delhi, but his succession was not supported by Muslim nobles and also Muslim subjects, and they sent an invitation to this Iltutmish, the governor of Badaun province and also the son-in-law of Aibak, to rule over Delhi. And this Iltutmish accepted that invitation and also assumed the throne of Delhi. With this, Iltutmish became the Sultan of Delhi region, or he started his rule under slave dynasty. So this is about Qutbuddin Aibak. And in my next class, I will going to discuss about Iltutmish. Thank you, students.